Thank you. My name is Chief Gordon Planas. I've been elected chief for up to 10 years now. My traditional name is Hayakacha. I'm named after my great-grandfather from Chiana, the Sama people. I lived in the village of Siosu, means the sounds the pebbles make when they're being washed up on our shores. I want to acknowledge the land that I'm on, the ancestors that walked on these lands. I'm very glad to be here, to be a part of this. I want to also acknowledge all the people that took their time to come into a circle, and the ones that organized this. It takes a lot of work. We have to, maybe before we start anything, let's have a hand for the people that put this together. I just want to maybe just a little bit of a snapshot of our community itself. We're on the west coast of Vancouver Island, in the province of British Columbia, in Canada. We have a small community. We put together our community a plan that focuses 100 years ahead for our children not born yet. And it gives us a totally different perspective on how to live. And one of the four pillars that we did do, you'll find interesting. The last one out of the four is economic development, because we found the environment comes first. With the environment comes water, and we find without those, then we will not survive, and our children that aren't born yet will not survive. And also with that, culture, because we find that our elders say if we have a strong culture, we know how to take care of the Mother Earth and make sure we have clean water. And the other one is using the elements that are around us, and that would be food security being one. Right now we're growing 4.5 million oysters in our basin. One day soon we're going to be growing 40 million. We're harvesting 4.5. For some funny reason, we are growing 15,000 wasabi plants, which we have harvested in the last year and a half. It's done very good for us. And then the other thing too is, we live in Canada, but who's to say we might be growing pot soon. Medicinal marijuana, but I don't know if we'll be doing that. It's called sustainability. But anyway, the other one too is energy, the energy part. BC Hydro pays us, they send us a check for power, and that's kind of neat. I like that. I like that concept of a utility paying us. Now maybe we should start thinking like that. Let's turn this whole thing upside down and see what happens. And I think if we all think that way, we might live better. Also, we have half our homes on solar hot water. We have a smart energy group. And we work with a lot of First Nations across Canada. And we're doing it as not so much, all as one. And again, when you think about the seven generations, you do think differently. I just want to close, because I know it's been great, and I'm going to be speaking tomorrow. The last one we did in the four pillars was economic development. And when you do the economic development, you know you have a strong foundation before you do it. We know that the culture is strong. We know that the fundamental principles of Mother Earth are intact, our water, our air. If you can ensure those foods that only you have to go and get not very far from home, then we make positive changes. And those are the things that come to us. We don't have to worry about those. And also, it does take the greed out of the equation. So I'll leave it at that. I want to thank you very much. I respect you.